Welcome to the game.
Yo, what is up, guys? It's Air Just Cause here once again with Ella on the High Side Racing League. And tonight, we're here for the regular season finale. Here's, we can take the invite. Okay, we are here for, we need an invite.
Slacking tonight.
Thank you, Jet. Jet saved the day.
Thank you, Jet.
Thank you, Jet. But we are here for the regular season finale and also my 200th race for the On the High Side Racing League. So let's get into it. I'm here with Mr. Smokin'. Reaper sadly is not here tonight and
he's not
may
in a good
not
mood.
Be here. Yeah, he's not in a good mood. Smokin', you got a copy there, buddy. Make sure your audio is included.
My audio is included and I got a copy.
Well, Daytona, you know, we all know how wild it can be. What's going to be the biggest factor here tonight?
Well, I mean, if it's anything like the B Series, my bottom lane is going to be everybody's friend.
Okay, well, we're still loading in because Caleb pulled an oopsie. But thank
Caleb,
you
what
for
do you expect?
Dryer. Yeah, my last invite to the game before Jet sent one was 19 minutes ago.
My last one before Jet sent me one was over an hour ago.
No one.
Ouch. Oh,
so, there we go. Down the. Oh, what?
Or it looked like someone went flying.
Are you seeing things?
Might be. Someone went flying,
well,
but anyway.
Here we go, as RA6 is up front with the 24, and then the 18 of Ian sitting in third. As here we go, heading down the back straightaway. So, Ray, what a good start here, as we only have 12 cars here tonight.
That's
this
two more than
the
B Series.
Interesting, but also could not be.
Two 24
is
going
to make a move to the outside.
He has no help.
And 24 is going to drop back down and then hit the apron and then go back up the racetrack and then, you know, get back down the racetrack to the yellow line. As the 8's going to make a run on the outside, see if he can get some help coming with him. And no, he will not here, Smokin'.
No, 6 is just loving that. I mean, it's early. You don't expect really anybody to make big moves yet. I mean, like I said, it's an 80-lap race. Oh, contact between the 8 and the 12. 18 and the 12, sorry. Blech. But they're just riding right now, getting a feel of what their car can do. I love Ian's paint scheme there, that good old Halloween festivity car. But yeah, it looks like Jet's going to get all the way shuffled back to the end of this line, and Slight's making a move on the outside of, can't tell who that is. I think that's, well, he was looking for someone. Anyway, back
well, right
to the
now,
train.
You're back to the Thomas the Tank Engine-like train.
Never mind, two
it's
bricks out.
Going on.
Who wants
well,
the lead?
Here we go, two's going to... Yeah, but he's got no help. He's got the 12 coming, but, you know, really no help. They're going to be outmatched on the bottom. So, already, you're sitting here, you're already at a disadvantage with, you know, that top side, you know, not getting enough cars. But, oh, the 6 is going to jump up high, carry the top, but the 2 is going to bail on him.
I saw that coming.
And Ding's going to go to the lead with Jet Dryer up the 2nd. And then, Trick up the 3rd.
Yeah, I saw that come in eventually, but how about that? You got one car apparently just got a lag from what I heard.
Oh, Here we go. 41's going to try the outside by himself, but has nowhere to go.
Well, he's got some help a little bit with that 6 trying to get up there, but now he's got the 17. Well, the 6 is trying.
17!
Well, the 6 is right behind him.
Oh, 17's on the apron. Oh, 12 with a huge run, but 24 bails on him.
Here comes the one with a huge run on the out of turn number in turn two.
Oh, here comes Savage. He won Indy on Tuesday. He's looking to see if he can go back to back here tonight. Comes 17 of Joe Boo. Gonna push on that bottom. Sadly, no hot seats here tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, 18.
Oh, 9's around.
9's around. 41's
involved.
In it.
It looked like it was lag from
like
the one
only
to one.
Two cars.
It was a lag from the one. I saw it.
Yeah, only two cars.
I saw
so
it. I was on the
it's
one.
It's not gonna be a caution. Oh, and the 41 stuck on the apron.
Is he actually stuck on the apron?
Yes, he is stuck on the apron. Oh, now he spawned out of the apron. Okay.
I personally think they
gave him the spawn.
Yeah, I personally think there should be a caution for that. That was two, but anyway.
All right, now it looks like now it's going to be a 6-car pack here that might be battling for the stage win here at Daytona.
You guys have to pit, Caleb.
Okay. So we're hearing the one glitched at the same time Ian went down. 17
and
to
four.
Go. They will have to pit one time. So, yes, smoking, they will have to pit one time.
I was just furious, okay?
I'm just furious, okay? What you eating?
I'm eating good old Smart Food white cheddar popcorn. And also I have just CBD gummies as well.
What CCC who?
I have CBD just gummies as well.
Oh.
I also got Chipotle.
Oh, okay. Chipotle? Wait, what?
I got Chipotle.
Chipotle?
Okay? I got Chipotle. Okay?
Chipotle?
Yes, I said Chipotle. Okay, you can add that to the,
yes, Chipotle.
The things Smokin' says.
I'm gonna add that to the dictionary.
I'm gonna kill you, Jax. Get the fuck in my room.
Whoa!
Sorry!
He never is. I think he just turned his dog into Chinese food.
No, he took a piss in the bathroom, so of course I'm gonna yell at him. Anyway, sorry about that. Let's go back to the race.
That dog is now a hot dog.
Again, I just said why I yelled at him.
God, that was hilarious. That was a very interesting. That might be a blooper on the blooper reel. Him screaming at his dog was so funny.
I kind of cannot wait to rewatch this just to hear that. I want to apologize to the viewers for that. Sorry.
Well, here comes the 12. 12's going to have a little bit of a run here. But he's going to have no help. Big checkup, 3 wide. So the 1's going to take the 4th spot. But they're going to get a good run right here, though. If they can get together and start pushing, these 3 could contend with the 3 up here. Currently, top 3 is currently being dominated by Fords. As right now, it's the 2, the 6, and the 17 currently your top 3 here, Smokin'.
Yeah. I want to apologize to all the viewers first off. Sorry about that. But, yeah, some single-file racing. But, okay, some good racing here. You got the 2, or you got the 12 and the 24 trying to work that high side.
Well, as here we go, heading into turns 1 and 2, 2, 6, and 17, your top 3 is smoking, just randomly stopped talking.
No, I was apologizing to the viewers, and I was talking about the battle between the 24 and the 12 working together.
Are you sure? Because you went silent for about a good straightaway.
It's single file, what do you want me to do?
Talk? What's up, Sarge?
Okay.
Why are we pitting here?
Apparently, Caleb's group's coming in next.
Next time? Wait, huh? What? They're getting some weird information from our guys. I don't know if we're pitting. I don't know if we're flipping. I don't know if we're going over the catch fence. I don't know what we're doing. But right now, currently, with the how spread out the packs are right now, you got the 2, you got the 6, you got the 17, your top 3. It's basically a 6-car pack up front in the first pack. But right now, you know, the way this stage is playing out here, Smokin', you know, you don't know how it's going to go. So 24 is going to make a run here on the outside, Smokin'.
Yep, we got 3 cars working together on that high line. And a little contact, they all separated.
Yeah, they keep messing up on the outside. If they want to get that outside going, they're going to need to, you know, start getting in line, start getting better pushes, start getting better runs, you know. Right now, they've just been kind of, they've gotten the runs. It's just the bottom lane is separating them. Kind of a smart strategy, trying to separate the outside line while they have the momentum to stop the momentum. So, as here we go. We got cars, they're pitting. I think we got some cars pitting. We're gonna have the Fords, yeah. Fords, I think, signaled. So the Fords
that's
might
what it
be
looks,
pinned.
That's
the ones
what it
gonna
like
go
there.
Around
they,
the outside.
Looks like they did signal there.
Yeah, it looked like they signaled. Okay, so they're pitting. Everyone's pitting. Everyone in this top 6 is gonna come down pit road.
Oh, 6 to the lead.
Six is gonna escape with the lead there. Out of that pack is, you know, I think we're gonna have more cars gonna stay out here though. 18's gonna come down. We did have a mini crash at the beginning of the race that kind of separated these packs, so can't wait to see how it's gonna go. There's Ding, he's on pit road. Look at the rest of the field. The rest of the field's really spread out when you look at it on the racetrack here, Smokin'.
Yeah, it's gonna come all about that. It's all about the entry and the exit of pit road.
Caleb over the radio says you need tires, you idiot. Personally, those tires are overrated. At Daytona, those tires are overrated, let me tell you. See, Sarge says, gotta remember, rubbing is racing. Oh, God. Yes, rubbing is racing if you flip somebody into a catch fence. You know, that's always great. But right now, you look 2 and 6 here. Going to be going against a 3-car pack right here, Smokin', as already these pit stop cycles, I think, have cycled out right here.
Yeah, it's some good racing here, down, especially down the back, front straightaway. Front 2, it looks like it is the 2 and the 6 working together. Trouble, please lay down.
Yeah, looks... Okay, so he tells his dog to lay down. That's some great analysis right there.
He's standing up in the middle of the race when I'm trying to watch the race, so I can't really.
Oh, huge run! It kind of stalled out. Yeah, that run stalled out. So, the 12's gonna go underneath the 24. I don't know what's going on back here, but it looks like that plan failed. Looks like that plan just failed. Now everybody's got to bail. They ain't the only things that's overflattened with drivers. It's just their tires. It's their egos. True, true, true. Egos. Egos is the one thing everyone has. Let's see. Everyone else is spread out except for this.
Hey, Bigsby, set alarm for 8:45.
Set alarm for 8:45. Where does that say that on the racetrack, Smokin? Is there a timer I don't know about? We got timers at the racetrack. Nice. Go. Right now the 2:06:17. Oh wow, Ford's really dominating this front pack right now. Here at
There's only
Daytona.
One Chevy.
Yeah, there's only one Chevy. There's four Fords.
And guess what that one lone Chevy is?
Yep. It's the 24. Hey, I told you, it took us having a small field at Daytona for everyone to listen to me. The only way you beat Hendrick at plate tracks is if you team together. Well, guess what? Yes, one of them got wrecked. But, there's always a but. But,
it's a long race.
It's going to be interesting to see what happens. Yeah, it is a long race. It's Daytona. There could be cautions. There could be cautions here in this second or first stage, but also the final stage when these races start getting down to the wire. We're here in 24 having overheating issue. How many? Fortigo? We're coming to Fortigo? Fortigo? Coming to Fortigo, stage one? Right now. So here we go through the trial, four laps to go. Here in stage
Caleb,
number
he's
one,
normally,
until some
Caleb, he's normally
state...
up front.
Yeah, he's normally up front leading the pack 24. He was having overheating issues due to the tape. How much tape did he even put it on?
I don't want to hear this too.
He put it on 55. That's what we're. Are you out of your mind? Usually 45's the max. Oh, 45 is the max. 55 is like expect to put you on a custom setup. He's flirting with overheating. Right now, you could cook a steak on his engine. That's how much he's overheating. Speaking of steak and beef, as we got, I think, three to go in the stage. I think it's three or two to go. I think whichever one.
I'll tell you what, though, I don't think that six is going to hang out much longer. I think he wants the stage one, too.
Well, we're also coming up on a lap car. It's the nine of tricks. So, you know, possibility could get lapped right here is very highly. You're going to have to look at it from a point of view. If you're the nine, do you start blocking like that psycho ex-girlfriend that wants you back, but you don't want to date her? So, or do you want to be safe? Or do you kind of want to be safe? You know?
I mean, he's literally giving you his thing. He wants to, he's going to block. I was going to say, I don't think he's, they're not. Andy, they're not catching you at all.
Well, here we go. Through three and four, we're going to be coming to one to go in the stage. Two to go. You said two to go last time! Oh.
Now they're coming to one to go.
This is my 200th race, Caleb, please. Why one to go? One to go in the stage. Caleb's about to give me a migraine. God. Oh, 17 hits the apron down the back straightaway. Oh, who's going to make the move? Is the 17 going to back off?
They're not catching Andy. Andy's got it.
Well, here we go. Out of turn number four.
Well, they won't catch you once you shut the light.
Because I think this is technically a bow for points.
Dude, you hit the line.
And
they're done.
Tua Ding's going to win stage one.
See, now you're
going to
pull away from him
Daytona. Good stage win. See, Starch says, well, that's cool timers and dogs. I like your fellow announcer, lol. Hey, Sarge likes you smoking. Of course, smell like usual. Smoking's already ignoring me.
What?
Here.
I didn't know you called me. I was talking
I'm
to
saying,
you.
Sarge in our chat likes you.
Oh, hi.
Talking about timers and dogs. What dog do you even have?
Me or?
Yeah. No, the invisible
he's
guy
a,
right next to you.
He's
smoking.
A pit. I have three. He one of them.
You have
a
pit bull?
Well, he's a pit mix. His name's Trouble.
Oh, pit mix.
Yeah.
But still aw.
And then I have Pitbulls a Boston so Terrier adorable. Schnauzer. His name's Jackson. And then I have a Jack Russell B-girl mix. Her name is Summer.
B-girl?
Yeah. Funny thing is, we call Jackson. His middle name's Necrasian.
I knew he was going to mispronounce Beagle, but I didn't know
I
he was going to
say Beagle. I said Beagle, okay? Beagle.
He's next thing you know, Smokin's going to call a Beagle a bagel. This is my bagel. This is my dog, Bagel. He's a Boston bagel. Green flag.
Oh, my God. Slight, yep.
22 to go stage 2. Are you sure, Caleb? It's
no, Slight's on the lead lap. Slight's on the lead lap. He's just...
Oh, yes. He
just
does
stay with the pack,
have to pay.
Then.
He has four
Andy,
laps
don't
of
lose
fuel.
The pack.
So hearing the one stayed out for some reason on a weird strategy. I've never heard of a strategy before, but he's only going to have four laps in the tank. So he might have to pit twice here in this stage. But here we go. Down the back straightaway. The two on the outside hanging it pretty well. Not really on tires. Oh, the one's getting out of the way. Yeah, the yep. one the
he's
one
like
said
done.
He's gonna pull out.
Oh!
All around he goes! Into a couple cars! Crash! That's three cars! Caution out!
And Andy's back on the lead lap. Andy is back on the lead lap. Heads up.
Three car crash for the first caution of the race.
Andy, you good, man?
Remember, this is already going to be the beginning of maybe about a couple more cautions. Well, that kind of, well, the one wrecked, but it kind of helps the one, but it hurts the one. What's up, Princess Auto Racing? Well, you picked the wrong one car. He didn't have shiny teeth. Well,
all right, so just wondering, your mega, your mega guy in the C Series, is that actually Chip?
Yes, that is Chip Skylark, as we're green. 18 to go. Yes, it is Chip Skylark under a new gamer tag, but I will still call him Chip Skylark.
I know, right? Everybody calls him Chip.
There's nothing that's stopping me.
No, because it's what's the point of stopping that?
What's the point? I love singing. Shiny teeth in me, shiny teeth, shiny teeth. I remember.
Shoot,
Air,
you ready for this?
Sang that when he was in the Cup Series about a couple seasons ago. Somebody said I should be singing in a church, bro. I should be in a church choir.
Well,
bro.
You want to know something funny? I was actually jamming. I put my contact with the 17 in the.
Oh, big contact.
But anyway, I was going to work. I was literally I threw on my playlist and I was literally jamming to Shiny Teeth earlier.
Dude, Shiny Teeth a cult classic.
Oh, 6-1. Little contact there between the 6 and the 1.
That took a little problems. That was a little bit worrisome.
I'll tell you one car that's happy. 24
gonna have a big run.
Yeah, this
Watch
is gonna
out
be...
for the 24 right here. He's gonna have a huge run on the leader and the 2's all by himself.
Here we go, battle for the lead.
Oh, he threw a pretty good block. Here comes the 3. Here comes Killer! Huge run from the three!
Come on, Killer!
The underdog! The well, three!
Wouldn't Caleb... Could you count Caleb as an underdog here at Daytona? Or is it just Killer?
I don't know. I count Caleb as an underdog everywhere.
Yeah, why couldn't we have Caleb... this insane draft on the freaking B series? Because there was no way it was a good draft.
Because Yoshi messed up the lobby smoking. Yes, I know. You're mad. You can have your therapy later, but you know, right now.
I'm already having my therapy. I got my gummy. I got my CBD gummies. I'm good.
Yeah, he's got his edibles. He's got his edible gummies and.
I got my happy gummies.
He's got his happy go lucky gummies. 24 lost some momentum, so he's going to fall back to fifth in this pack. Let's see. Sarge says I need to get my truck and drive on this track. If you know what I'm saying, just cause. Yeah, I remember. Oh, I remember. It was wild, but I remember. let's see. Right now we're on board with the 12 of Jet. Oh, the 2. I think may have hit something, but it's going to shuffle the 6 out of line right there. That's going to bring the 6. Lose a lot of spots. And the 6 is going to have no help. He's the lonely. Oh, the 9's around on the apron. Saved it. What a save by the 9.
Well, it just sounds like he hit the glitch. I feel bad for it.
He hit the glitch spot on the apron, yeah. But the question is, why are you doing too low down there to hit it?
God. No!
Get off my apron. I just heard Caleb yell, get off my apron like an old man telling kids to get off his lawn.
Andy, you gotta remember, man, that's Caleb's like, wife that you just got on, okay?
Get off my apron. I just imagine Caleb saying that, shaking like a walker.
Oh
like
my god.
Having a walker on his front porch and about to chuck it at the kids.
I can see it
about
too.
To chuck it.
I can
like,
see it.
Get off my apron.
Little Colin just went on Caleb's apron.
Because they drive like I do. Well, let's see what happens. I mean, we still got a long way in the stage.
I mean, Andy, you're not really on the apron. You're more in on the track in turn 3 and 4.
He's on the
okay,
apron.
Okay, now you're on the apron.
He's making fun of Caleb.
Next thing
you know, he's going to take the bus stop, and we're going to start riding the Daytona road course.
I can see him doing
we'll
it.
We'll be turning left and right. All I know, Jet Dreyer is still a G for taking the jump at Canadian Tire a couple of races ago.
No, it wasn't Jet Dreyer. No, it was.
I was in the hot seat.
It was Jack. It was Jack.
And Reaper had the biggest temper tantrum I've ever heard, even worse than a toddler that was on my plane to Germany. Lol. He's got my wife's wife. Whoa, wait. He's got wife beater syndrome? What? One? Whoa. That's a little bit out of pocket. Two? I don't know. That's interesting. Okay.
Funny thing is, it wasn't Jet Dreyer that went the jump. It was Jack Baseball.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Big run on the outside from the 6. Oh, looks like the 3 and the 12 are trying to go on the outside. And the 6 is going to go to the lead. So B13 to the lead. We documented that B13 is currently winless on the season. You know, hasn't won a race yet.
Oh!
Ooh! 12 and 2 making some contact. Remember, one of the bigger battles. One of the big. Wow, a nice voice crack, buddy. Ran out of oxygen enough? But, well, right now, with the six currently up front. 17. By the way, we also want to mention another battle is the battle, I think, for first in points, right? Between Colin and Ding. Okay, so we're hearing Ding is 1 point above Colin.
But wouldn't Colin technically be ahead now since Colin's ahead of Ding?
Well, we don't do live points.
I thought we did. Sorry.
We technically do after stage points. We'll get a report after stage. It's stage two, Princess.
I didn't find it funny. I'm sorry. It's funny. Yeah, these runs are ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, they're getting huge runs from the high draft. You know, of course, you're going to get huge.
Wish the B-Series had it.
Go around that outside. Yeah, you wish. It should. Yeah, Yoshi messed up the lobby because they had low draft at the previous race at Indy.
So mad I freaking won.
So he messed up the lobby. They had low draft, and Mr. Southern went on the win, not only stage one and two, but the race.
Yeah, he was dominant.
Yeah, he dominated that whole race. The saddest thing was there was probably about five cars contending for the win.
That's the thing. This was my chance to get my hot seat.
Okay, what happened to your hot seat?
I finished 10th, and I had work.
You had work, so you... Oh, yeah, I forget. You sell phones. You work at T-Mobile, yeah. I forgot.
Hey, I got my first commission check today. Whoop, whoop!
Hey, W's!
And I get paid next week, too.
W's! He got paid!
Yeah, my commission.
Woo, woo! That's what it sounds like when you always get your paycheck, man. Like, woo, woo! Woo, woo! thank you, Killer, for congratulating me on the 200 race.
You know who hasn't jumped in your stream in a while, Air?
Who?
Killer's girlfriend.
Oh, yeah! Where is Sarah?
What? Dude, I'll just jump in Discord and ask that same thing.
I haven't seen her check into one of my races in a while.
It has been a while. Oh!
Yo, Sarge says, boy, when he's talking about his hot seat, he went quiet all of a sudden. Those gummies must be good.
I mean, hey, who said that who said that?
Sarge.
Hey Sarge, I got a whole little container if you want some. I mean, I'll send a picture.
Yo, hey, sharing's caring.
Exactly.
You gotta share some.
I mean, they're 250 milligrams, but I'm good.
You want some edibles? So here we go.
Dude, the gummy worms I had, they were like 600.
Oh, crash!
Is your ex
big trouble? Oh yeah, there's four or one. The four's around. 41's in the wall. 12 with heavy damage.
So I smell caution.
Is there? I don't think there's a caution. Yeah, there's no caution. I think. Yeah, just so you know, there's a crash. The two's gonna exit out of pit road, all by himself. Must be a strategy here. Must be getting a strategy right here. Six. Well, the six is in. Oh, six is going to be the last one exiting. He must have had a issue.
So, we got some good racing going on right now.
Yeah, but we're under pit cycle. I don't know how many to go it is. Three? Okay, it's three to go now? Okay.
And well, the
three's exiting pit road. And he's exiting out all by himself. Here comes the two.
Wait, whoa, wait. Did I hear that right? Caleb leads?
Yeah, but his car is all damaged.
Ah.
Right? I mean, I saw him spin into a wall. Is Caleb actually the leader?
Yes.
And we're coming to two to go, right?
So here's the question. Caleb has to pit this time, or he's going to try to run it out.
Three to go.
Hey, three to go.
But here's another thing. He's also gaining on a car, so he might be able to save a little bit of gas here. There you go. There's the answer. Caleb has been saving. I need a margarita. See, anybody want to go get margaritas?
Hey, I can't drink. I'm 19.
Shoot, Air, I'll just come up to Cincinnati and bring you a beer.
I don't live in Cincinnati.
Or I'll just come up to Cleveland or whatever. Wherever you're at.
Wrong side of Ohio.
Oh, Caleb's coming in.
Okay, Caleb's coming in. He's going to make his final stop of the stage. Let's see. Princess Auto Racing says you need a PB. I need a PB, like a PB&J? Like a PB&J would be... It'd be amazing, actually. Send me an invite. I'll join the booth. BP. You need a Betty Parsons. Okay, thank you for saying it, because, yeah. Do you want Princess in the booth? I mean, so we're about to head into the final stage.
Here's my question. Why doesn't Tom Brady just leave the Bucks right now and go to the backup and just call it a season?
Because Tom Brady is about to get divorced.
Well, I mean,
he probably wants to play the rest.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, the Ravens lead 24-13 over the Bucks.
It was just 10-3 like a quarter ago.
Evidently not. Now they're in the fourth.
Well, it's over. Tom Brady's washed.
Yep, Tom Brady has finally been washed out. So it was 10-3. It was 10-3 at halftime. Okay, but K. Drake with the short pass and Jackson with another pass.
Well.
So,
well,
yeah,
we go through the trial.
14.3.
And that's going to end the stage. That's going to end the stage. Ding is going to win stage two. He wins stage two. And that's going to put him a big points lead now, or at least a sizable points lead on the 24.
And there's a whole nother stage there.
Chat. Sarge says, hey, just cause you took the words right out of my mouth with sharing is caring. Sharing is caring.
So who's trying to join the booth with us?
I think it's Princess. Princess Auto Racing.
Well, shoot, invite her. Or him, or whatever.
I forget, is that Skylark? I forget, is Skylark Princess?
I don't know.
Ooh, it's a 7-point gap. Well, this final stage is going to get interesting. No. Okay, well, I don't remember who you are. I don't have your gamer tag. I think I don't have your gamer tag. I wish Shiny Teeth Machine, though. Shiny Teeth and me, Shiny Teeth, Shiny Teeth. Here we go. Green flag, final stage of the regular season here. 28 laps to decide the regular season finale. If you want to talk about underdogs, just look who's behind the two car. You got the 3 of Killer in second. You got the 18 of Ian in third. You got Savage in four. Well, Savage just recently won an Indy.
Well, here's the thing. Eric, this is where Sarah would really jump in. This is where Sarah would be nice to have in the chat, because to be, you know her, she would be like, go Killer. And now look, the fact that Killer is up here in the top two, about to battle for the lead, it's ridiculous. It's crazy, because normally you see him as a back marker.
Yeah, and I mean, that's what's the factor of Daytona and Talladega does. It brings anyone into this race. The thing is, if Killer or Ian pull out a line, is anybody going with them?
I mean, honestly, if I'm the 24, I mean, you got nothing to lose. If you're going to get to the front, you got nothing to lose. I say go with them if they pull out, but...
Really, I mean, is anybody willing to push the 3 or the 18 to a victory?
No. There you go, the 9 is.
Hey, just like Toy Story, you got a friend in me.
Well, 18's going to the rear.
Yeah, 18's going to fall to the rear, got shuffled out of line.
Jeez. Yeah, sixth
well,
place.
Here we
Woo-hoo.
Go. We got one car. Oh! I think I just saw a
That's
car
Caleb.
Just
that was
violently
Caleb.
Hit the wall.
That was Caleb.
Let me guess. Did Caleb hit the apron?
I think Caleb did hit the apron. No!
Oh!
And there goes Killer.
3 gets shuffled out of line.
There goes Killer.
Yeah, Killer's going to get shuffled out of line there in the 3. Now he's going to lose spots.
Move the 9 up to 5th. Yeah, something hit, the 24 hit something. Well, there goes Caleb's race. Bye, Caleb. Oh, Caleb, you're not the only one. Hunter Boy lost the draft too, so maybe you guys can team up a little bit. I see that. Yep, you're like literally right there. Anyway, back in front, 2 leads. 17's got a hell of a run. Someone's got to pass this too. Oh, one's in the wall.
Slingshot engaged.
I think I invited the right person. There we go. I was searching up somebody's gamer tag.
Wait, what now? What now, Colin? What would
I was searching
say?
Up Princess Zana gamer tag. He says he's going to hop in for a little bit. There we go.
So, Colin, what'd you say?
Because right now we're looking at the... Yeah, this is basically... Because it's a 12-car field. This is basically the whole field that's going to battle for the win.
It's still early. You got pit stops still. Don't forget about those.
Oh, 24 making the move. But nobody's going to go with them except for the 6. Oh, the 24 cuts them off. Oh, they're 3 wide. Drop. Go to ignition and put the sliders up. That's what this man just said. This man just said, go put the sliders on. But, let's see. Well, hold on. If y'all can get single file for a moment, we can do the special part of the race. Hold on. Let's see. 24 gonna go high.
And he's going with them.
Here comes the 9. Here comes the 12. Oh, 12's not gonna go with them.
12 was trying.
12 was actually going to leave him out to dry.
Nope, 12 was coming up. He was trying.
Hold on, boys.
And you got some cars moving to the outside behind the 9. The 6 and the 3.
Yeah, you got the 12. You got the 3 as well.
The 6 is up there.
I don't know. That inside line.
One more car and that should put that house.
Yeah, I mean, that outside line's lost momentum.
Give it a second.
Oh,
probably...
the 1's going to go with them, but the 12 goes to the bottom. So
no, they'll be
one.
Going with her. just, oh man.
I mean, it's insane how much they swap spots around here. Okay, who's ready? Because guess who's showing up to Daytona, folks?
Not yet. They're still doing it. They're still going at it. They're still... Alright, gotta go now, Air. It's dying down. And cue the music! Jarvis, you need an invite.
There we go. Thomas the Tank Engine has arrived here.
Here you go, Garbage Man. I sent you an invite so you can join us in the booth.
Yeah, I invited him. I think I invited the game.
I just sent him an invite just to get him in.
Yeah, I need to erase. Okay. Okay, hold on. Let me refresh my stream on my tablet so I can...
What do you mean?
Get a refresh. I need to refresh the stream on my tablet just in case. Is there currently single file Thomas the Tank Engine style? Thank you for knowing that my audio is okay.
Yeah, your audio is great, man.
My audio is amazing.
It's awesome. As long as it doesn't do what it did on the B series on Sunday, we'll be okay.
What in the Looney Tunes soundtrack? It's Thomas the Tank Engine. It's Thomas! No! Right now, this top four, they've made a little bit of a gap between them and fifth, but they're going to need to figure out how to stay together here because this second pack is going to have a major momentum once they catch to them. This is going to get interesting because now, who blocks?
All of them.
All of them? You're assuming everyone. We're gonna go V formation, okay? You're gonna have the two, and then you're gonna have the eight.
Flying V, boys. Flying V.
Oh, 41 around. With a spin. That is not good. 12 goes outside. That's going to slow some momentum down. Here comes the 3 on the bottom. 6 is going to go to the top here with the 9, but that inside line, clearly it looks like nobody wants to battle with the 2 today. I guess everybody's like, we're going to push the 2 today. Yeah, that is a question. When is pit stops going to happen? How many to go do we got?
Yeah, we're coming to the point in the race now where pit stops will start coming to play. Come down to the end of the race.
I knew it. I knew it was Mr. Shiny Teeth in me. He couldn't.
Pit stops are going to be crucial now.
He couldn't bull jive. He couldn't bull jive me.
They're going to have to make sure not the spit. They're going to have to make sure not the speed.
I knew it.
Now, where you race with me and see, you know how hard it is trying to coordinate these pit stops. Can you kind of talk about that for a minute?
Oh yeah, it's, you know how you coordinate these pit stops here. You know, you gotta work with everyone around you. You gotta know how you gotta enter pit road. You know, gotta make sure you keep it clean. Make sure you give enough people space. You know, you want to enter lower, give somebody like second behind you more space to, you know, go around the top of you, or if you're the leader, you might enter higher so everybody can enter below you. You know, you gotta just work together so you don't wreck each other trying to enter pit road. I think that's where it starts getting a little dangerous, is when everybody's trying to fit 3 large cars into a very small space on pit road.
Exactly, and you don't want to be that guy that makes someone else become the black flag. That's never a good sign.
You always feel bad after that.
Yeah, you don't want to give anybody a black flag, which means penalty. Penalty. Well, right now it's still single file. It looks like nobody really wants to pass the two right now. I guess everybody's just calm to make it to pit stops and then see what happens from there.
It is the calm before the storm.
Oh, they're pinned now. Speaking of pit stops. Well, yeah, I think the whole field's pinned. So here we go. Pit stops, folks. Oh, here we go. This is how you're going to enter.
If I was the 12 on back, I'd hang him out. I go a different route. But...
Oh, 17, 24, 18 around.
And the 24 gets a black flag off the bumper of the 17.
Yeah, 24 black flags.
And the 24
up road.
Throws in the towel.
Well, there goes his chance to do the Daytona.
Well, unless a caution comes out. I mean, unless a caution comes out, you know, the only reason this hurts the 24 is because it basically confirms the two as the regular season points champ.
Hey, congratulations to him.
That's the only thing that hurts the 24. Now, if he can get a lucky break, you know, it's the 6 actually. Oh, no, the 2 wins the race off pit road.
Now, does the 24 actually quit, or does he,
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering. No, he's still racing. He's just going to have to hope for a caution. I mean, a caution's going to have to be huge for him.
Yep.
Fitting 3 large cars that could be taken out of context. I love it. God. Yeah, out of context moment might make the compilation, but,
Yeah, and unfortunately for the 24, his race is just kind of in the hands of someone else's mistake. Kind of hoping someone that misaligns a bumper and gets spun. You're kind of hoping for someone else's bad luck, but that's all he's got right now.
Well, right now, another thing you got to talk about is the packs now after these pit stops. You got 2 3-car packs, basically. This is basically for a win. You got Savage, who the second pack, which Savage is leading. Savage, who recently won an Indy on Tuesday. He got his second career A-Series win at Indianapolis. He's leading this pack. Then you got Killer in the second car in that pack. We don't talk about Killer much because he's usually in the back of the field. You know, he's not really
one
of those fast cars. But he's been actually holding his own lately. You know, when it comes to positions, he holds it for a while, but starts falling back slowly. You know, so he's just lost a spot to the 12. And then you got the 12 of Jet Dryer. Remember, Jet Dryer in the 500 had the lead with 5 to go, and he lost the race because of an issue and basically lost the 500. He did get redemption the next race at Auto Club, getting the win. Sadly...
His issue just a nice way of saying choked.
No.
He had an issue
with something. He had to pull and park the car on the backstretch infield. So, which wasn't good.
No.
Now, the front pack. You got the Tua Ding, who's been on his best season yet. He's probably the favorite to win the championship this season with all the wins he's gotten, all the stage wins. All of his good runs, he's probably the favorite or second favorite to win this championship. You got B13, who hasn't won a race this season. He is Ding's lagging. He's going to fall out of the lead. So B13's going to go to the lead. 9's going to make a move. 9 to the inside. Here comes Trick.
Yep. Ding's mother must
have... Bow for the lead.
Ding's mother must have turned on her e-reader or something.
So it sounds like basically the 24 raged. Or no, never mind.
Yeah, I think 24 raged.
See here? Yeah.
Sorry, I'm trying to figure out where's the Viagra car, because it usually is running hard. Oh my god.
That's the only car that has windshield wipers on the inside.
How many to go do we got? Eight to go? So eight to go, seven to go next time. It's basically a three-car battle. Unless the second pack can do anything. That second pack needs this first pack to start battling. That's what it needs. It needs this first pack needs to start battling for that second pack to take advantage.
And that first pack is not running pretty straight. They're banging off the banana peel pretty hard there. So if the second pack just stays in the line, doesn't try to mix it up, they might come close. They might be able to grab that draft. And there's three against three, so it's just going to be the cleanest line wins, basically, at this point.
Well, it's like I said, you have Trick, you know, who has a handful of wins this season, you know, but has run solid. You know, he's definitely going to be in the playoffs and definitely could be a championship four contender.
This is right on his card.
You got the six, the B13, who's been winless since last season, I think before the playoffs last season, so he's about to probably go over a whole season winless.
Wow.
You know, since his last win, you know, this could be his best shot to win right here. He's probably had other shots at a couple road courses this season. He's going to move out of line. Two's going to let him back in.
Yeah.
And of course, we're talking about Ding. Ding's had his best season yet. You know, probably, like I said, the favorite or the second favorite to win the championship.
I think Ding's in the better position here. You know, I'd rather be in a pack of three like that. I'd rather be the third car because you kind of at least you decide who wins. I mean, really, if the six pulls out, you know, he's just got to rely on that car behind him to give him help. But if it doesn't, then, you know, he's hung out to dry.
Yeah, you need to control fate,
yeah.
Basically, right here. If you're the two, you control fate.
And the two, you know, it's another wild card, too, because he's lagging. He never know. He might spike ahead. And I don't know if you've ever been spiked in front of a car that's lagging, but you cannot handle it. It just, you go flying. So that might, you never know. That might, this lagging might get worse. How many
nine
laps?
Nine with a low, almost got a lot of line. Speak of everything interesting tonight, I know after this, once midnight hits, I can't wait for Modern Warfare 2 to come out. That's going to be a game I'm going to be playing. So it says, now the drivers y'all have right now, right? They know who their sponsors are. Is that correct? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it says it on their car. I would be kind of sad if somebody didn't know their sponsor. I mean, right now, of course, you know, we got the lovely pink number 9 Hooters car. Who doesn't love Hooters?
I can think of a few people.
Well, those few people I call Karens, okay? And if they want to be Karens, you know, go ahead.
That might actually be their name, but yeah.
But Hooters is a lovely place. Then you got the Oscar Mayer Wiener car.
They got them.
You know,
there's
actually
a lot of
the Oscar Mayer Pro League Wiener car. Shout out to my boy Casey Masser, of course, Pro League driver for that six car. You know, my man Casey. And then, of course, you got three to go. You got a Patriotic Miller Lite because it's America. Hell yeah, America.
Uh oh.
America, baby.
Don't get banned.
I said America.
Okay. Someone else said the other part, but it's all right. First Amendment, right?
America! Heck yeah! Coming to three to go. Or not three to go, two to go, my bad.
Two to go.
And
this barn burner of event.
I'm just shocked about who's leading this race. I mean, he was literally about to go two laps down.
He was about to go two laps down earlier. This is how unpredictable Daytona is. He was about to go two laps down earlier. Now he's in the lead with two to go.
White.
Now the question is, if you're the six or the two, do you stop Andy by taking this win from him? And when do you make the move?
I think
they're trying to make the move. This,
I think,
I'm just saying this. This would be the funniest thing. What happens if the 6 makes the move, the 9 blocks, they wreck the top 3, and then the 12 and 1 wreck, and Killer goes on and wins the race?
I mean, that could still happen.
Dismissing all of it. I would be laughing. But here we go.
Coming to the white flag.
Turn number 4.
Here they come.
We're going to be coming to the white flag. One more lap remaining here for the regular season finale.
I think them two when Fords are going to gang up on them.
I was going to say, yeah, when do those Fords make the moves?
Yeah.
The I moved?
Say, or the moves.
Yeah.
I say go now. Moves. I say personally, I say go right here. There you go.
Oh, the two, oh, there we go.
6 guys.
9 with a block.
You know Andy's going to block like crazy. Cyclonex girlfriend alert. Here we go.
Oh.
2's in the wall.
6 is on the outside.
Oh,
but he
boy.
Needs help.
He's got ding.
It's over.
He's got ding. Their contact.
He got him.
Here we go. Out of turn 4.
He's got a hell of a run.
Oh,
he's
contact.
Got him.
Here
6
we
is
go.
Gonna get it. 6
being,
gonna get it.
He wants the 6. He won the 6.
He really did that.
Trick's gonna win at Daytona.
Wow. That's just. That's
he wound
just...
him.
Yeah, that's that's.
Well, hell's
reason.
About to break loose in the good old fashioned. I don't think. I don't
oh,
think
oh, it... oh! They're fighting. That we're gonna have. We got beef.
Yeah, but I knew it was coming.
I knew it was coming.
I could see it coming.
Beef.
I knew it was coming eventually.
We got beef.
Where's the beef? I don't hear it.
Give him a second.
Beef. Hey, remember, beef. It's what's for dinner.
I don't hear.
Yeah,
don't,
let's go, Rock. Yeah, type in beef.
I don't hear no beef.
Beef.
Give it a second.
No,
it
there's none.
Be.
There's
I mean,
none. Aw.
That's high side racing in a box there. You know, you never know. You never know what'll happen on the last lap.
Well, I think this basically confirms Ding is the regular season points winner or champion.
He's something.
So. Let's just see what happened. That took about a little over an hour to do, surprisingly. So, that was actually a pretty quick race. Whoa, okay, that's a very interesting way to end your race. God. Exit. Leave the lobby. Well, let's see. Let's go ahead and interview your top 3. Let's start with your third place finisher here tonight, Ding, who gets a job done in P3. And also... is your regular season points champion. Dang, you got a copy there, buddy?
Yep.
Well, you set out everything you needed to do there at the end of the race. You won stage 1, you won stage 2, and you finish ahead of the 24. Tell us, how does it feel? No, yeah, this is your best season yet. You come out now with the regular season points champion.
I'm feeling pretty good. Job ain't over, though. We got the actual playoffs, so regular season championship's cool, but eyes are on the prize now.
Yeah, definitely eyes are on the prize now. Tell us, you know, didn't get the win. You know, was trying to help the 6 there at the end at all, or, you know, was trying to think of a move and just didn't,
he
you
helped
know,
him.
Open up there?
I had heard that I was lagging a little bit, so I backed off and decided to stay back a little bit, try and not do any damage to anybody. I was going to follow the 6 to whatever move he would make, and then unfortunately coming off a 4, the 9 pushed him up into the wall. So, you know, wasn't all what was wanted, but still a good finish for me. So, not too bad to get the regular season championship. Feel pretty good about that, but we'll keep the try and keep the momentum going here.
Okay. Well, anything you want to say or shout out here before we move on to your second place finisher tonight?
Shout out to you. Congratulations on your 200th race tonight. Shout out to Colin for hosting the league. It's been a lot of fun. And I believe we got kind of an off week tomorrow. We got the holidays with Highside going this next week. And then I think the week after is the start of the playoffs. So we're looking forward to that.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting because there's no B. I don't think there's any B or C series races this weekend. So
nope. It's,
oh no.
It's,
yeah.
It's just a little fun run. I don't know if you'll be documenting that or not.
A little off weekend for
I think
you.
I will be.
If you want. So. Oh, no.
Yeah. Well, congratulations on your P3 and the regular season championship, and we wish you good luck for a couple weeks here.
Thank you.
I'd ask him a question. I think he's got muted.
Okay, let's go on to your second place finish here tonight.
Silver.
Mr. B13, who gets this job done in P2, but almost had a shot at the win there at the end. B13, you got a copy there, buddy. Make sure your audio is included.
I've got here.
Well, it's tough, man. You know, you had it. It looked like you were going to have it at the line before the 9 kind of doored you into the wall there. Tell us, you know, what did you need more of right there to get the W here tonight?
Oh, I'm not really sure. He did get into me a little bit, but I think that's hard racing. You know, we're both battling for the win at the end there. I understand it was 2-on-1. You got to do what you got to do, so no hard feelings. It would have been nice to get my first win, but I think maybe if I would have tried to make a move earlier on, he probably wouldn't have blocked it so hard, but the two was lagging really bad, so I wasn't trying to do anything crazy with him jumping all over the place like he was, so we'll just have to settle for a 2.
Man, no animosity for the 9? Not at all?
No animosity, man. It's all good.
Hey, man, there you go.
I've blocked hard for a win here before, too. It happens.
Yeah, it definitely does. Tell us, though, you know, you solid finish, though. You're up front all race, but still winless on the season. I think you've now gone over a season since regular season of last season. Till now, you haven't gotten a win. You know,
I think his last win was actually Watkins Glen, wasn't it?
I have not won at all. This is my first winless season since my first season in high side, but yeah, I mean that sucks. Yeah, Martin Truex style, I guess. I don't know. I did make it into the playoffs, so I've got that. I don't know. I'm looking forward to the playoff schedule. I think I got some strong tracks coming up. Just got to try to do the best I can and keep getting good finishes. I'll find my way to victory lane one of these days. Playoffs do start at Texas.
Yeah. Well, Matt,
Texas. Wow.
Hey, man, Matt Crafton, he can win a championship without winning, so it's not possible.
It is possible, but I don't know about that.
Yeah, well, anything you want to say or shout out here before we go on to your winner here tonight?
Shout out, as always, to you, Air. Thank you for your great streams, and shout out to Highside. Yeah, thank you for another great race, and looking forward to the playoffs.
Okay. Well, congratulations on your P2. We wish you good luck for Texas in a couple weeks. No problem. Let's go on to your winner here tonight.
Winner, chicken dinner.
Trick, who gets it done, number 9. Trick, you got a copy there, buddy?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, make sure your audio is included. What a win, man. Had to hold off the 6 and the 2 there at the end. Tell us what was going through your mind right there towards the end of the race that you were outnumbered there at the end, and then you still pulled it off.
Well, I knew there would be I knew they would back up going into 1, and they did. I let off the gas, and car got a little loose. They went high, so had to block it, blocked all the way down the back. They definitely had the run on the outside there in 3 and 4, and kind of ran them up a little bit, hit them, slow them down kind of, and then didn't mean to put him in the wall on the front stretch. I meant to side draft him, and as soon as I went up, the car just yanked right, which was completely on me. Definitely didn't want to win like that, but I mean, the 3 of us still got great finishes, which is good. I'm glad there wasn't anybody else around us.
Good. I just got the notification the Ravens won. I just saw Rockin' Chat like, "Let's go, Ravens! Caw, caw! Caw, caw!" As, yeah, I knew the Ravens would win because Tom Brady's washed. But, you know, good win, winning the regular season finale and also my 200th race. How does it feel to get a win here at Daytona and build some momentum heading into the playoffs in a couple weeks?
It is absolutely amazing. Texas, for me, is really good track. So hopefully we can get the playoffs started in the right direction and go from there.
Okay. Well, anything you want to say or shout out here before we end the stream tonight?
Thank you, Air, as always, and congrats on 200 streams. Another Hendrick car won your anniversary race. Shout out to Colin for getting the league together and had fun tonight. Appreciate everybody.
Okay. Well, congratulations on your win. We wish you good luck again for a couple weeks here for Texas.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay, well, that's going to end the stream here tonight. Thank you for everyone tuning in and watching for my 200th Highside race tonight. 200 races.
And thank you for having me, buddy.
Yeah, thank you, for Skylark for being
The garbage man. It's just the garbage man. Yeah.
Okay,
just,
we're going to call him the garbage man, but you're still Skylark to me.
No, I don't know who that guy is. I'm a garbage man.
Stop acting. Okay, you can stop the act. You're a terrible actor. Man.
I mean, I'm like George Clooney here, man. Tom Cruise.
Okay. And I like to thank Smokin' for also being in the booth with me tonight.
Smokin'. Yeah. Coolest name.
Okay, of course, Smokin' must be those good.
I'm here.
Okay, and we'll see you guys for the next race. Thank you guys for watching.
Peace out.